Hi students, now we going to discuss about chapter 13 surface area and volume topic exercise 13.3 6th question up to 5 question last class we discuss. Today we will discuss 6th question. In 6th question they asking one silver coin is there like this. One silver coin is there. Diameter of that silver coin is given. Diameter is given as 1.75 centimeter. Diameter of the silver coin is given as diameter of the silver coin given as 1.75 centimeter. Then thickness is given as 2 millimeter. In this way they given thickness is this part. This part thickness is known as a thickness. This part here, see, this is 2 millimeter they given. Then such type, how many coins like this in this way? Here, how many coins are required to melting and make a cuboid shape? Length, breadth, height of that cuboid also they telling that. Such type cuboid, how many coins required to melting and making a cuboid? Length, breadth is given. This one cuboid shape. Cuboid shape is there. Cuboid shape, length, breadth, height also given there. Length is given as 5.5 centimeter. Breadth is given as 10 centimeter. Height is given as 3.5 centimeter. In this way they given. I hope you can understand the meaning. Question is once again, one silver coin is there. Diameter of that silver coin is given as 1.75. Thickness is given as 2 millimeter is given. This type, such type, how many silver coins, a number of coins asking required for melting and making this much measurement having a cuboid. They asking like that, how many such this type silver coin required for making this measurement cuboid. So how to find out why? Because same coin is used to convert to a cuboid shape. That's why volume of n coin is equal to the volume of the cuboid. So volume of n coin is equal to the volume of the cuboid. Then once you think here, coin is in which shape? Cylinder shape. So in number of n, we don't know how many coins required. That's why n number we are considered. Volume of n coin is equal to volume of the cuboid shape. Finding that you get in how many coins will required. So first given information. Diameter is given. Diameter of a coin is equal to 1.75 centimeter. That's why it's in, here point is there. We want to convert to point. How to convert to point? Remove point, divide after decimal point. How many digits are there? 2 digits are there. Divided with the 100. Then it will remove in 5 table. How many times? 5 table 15 means 3 times. Then 225 means 5. Here how many times? 20 times. Here 7, 4. So how much is 7 by 4 centimeter is the diameter. Then a radius asking. So we want to convert into radius. Radius of a coin is equal to half of this one. 2 is also in denominator. This 4 is in the, they both are in denominator. That's why we multiply and write 7 by 8 centimeter is the radius of a coin. Next, what information they given? Thickness is equal to the height of the coin. Thickness of a coin is equal to height of the coin. Height of the coin. How much they given a 2 millimeter. Yeah, one problem. Thickness is in millimeter. Remaining all are in centimeter. Convert millimeter to centimeter. 1 millimeter container. How much centimeter? 1/10 centimeter. Or 1 centimeter container. How many millimeter means 10 millimeter is there. Here number given as in smallest form. Convert to highest means divided division. So this much centimeter. Then next here length of the cuboid is given. Length of the cuboid is equal to 5.5 centimeter. Then next breadth of the cuboid they given. Breadth of the cuboid shape is given. So breadth of cuboid equal 10 centimeter. Here this is a decimal point. How to remove a divided with a 10. Then next height of the cuboid is given. So height of the cuboid is equal to how much they given a 3.5 centimeter. How to convert, remove decimal point divided with a 10. So later we can cancel it. Then what we want to do, volume of how many coins required, we don't know, we consider it as n volume of n coin. Coin is in which shape, a cylinder shape, is equal to volume of a cuboid. Volume of a cuboid. Same coin is used for melting and prepare cuboid shape. That's why volume of n coin is equal to volume of a cuboid. So n into what is the formula for finding volume of a cylinder? Pi r square, which is the formula. Volume of a cuboid is length into breadth into height is the formula. N into pi plus 22/7. Radius of a coin is how much we got? 7/8. R square is there. That's why 2 times right multiply height of the coin. Height of the coin is equal to thickness of the coin. That is 2/10 is equal to length into breadth into height. Length how much? 55/10 into height. Breadth given as how much? 10. Height given as 35/10. Cancelled and calculation doing 10 and 10 cancel. 7 table 35. So 5 table 35, 7 times. Then 5 table 10, how many times? 2 times. Again 2 and 10 cancel 1. 2 table 10, 5 times. Again 1, 7 we can cancel. Again 22 and 8, 2 table 11 times, 2 table 8, 4 times. Again 2 and 1, 4 we can cancel, 2 is there. Then again once this 7 and this 7 we are cancelling. Then 11 and 50, 11 table 55, 5 times. 11 table 11, 1 time. Numerator part full 1 only. So n by denominator part become how much? 2 into 8 into 5 is in the denominator. Here numerator part 5 only there. 5 only there. Then remaining part calculation doing them. Therefore n value is equal to 5 into 2 into this numerator goes to opposite side, comes to be numerator. Denominator goes to opposite side, comes to be numerator there. So 5 into 2 into 8 into 5 multiply. So n is equal to 5 5 are 25. 25 into 16 comes to be how much? 400. Number of coins, how many coins are this type, how many coins are required for making a cuboid shape? 400 coins are required for preparing this type of cuboid shape. This type of 400 coins are required for melting and making a this much measurement of cuboid. That is the meaning of this question. So n value become a 400. I hope you can understand this sixth question. Next seventh question tells about another thing is seventh question they telling about one cylinder shape bucket is there, cylindrical shape bucket is there. In that bucket full of sand is there. That's sand is put down on the ground and make it as a cone shape. Then what is the radius and the slant height of that conical heap is conical. People, that Sandy's make as a cone shape. That's why. First, here they mentioned that one is cylinder shape, bucket is there, bucket height, length, and height is given as 32 centimeter. Then radius, 32 centimeter radius given as a base radius. Base radius, bucket top part open. That's why base radius they given as 18 centimeter. Base radius given as 18 centimeter. Height of that bucket is given as 32 centimeter. It is full of sand is there. That is emptied on the ground. That full sand is emptied on the ground and make it as a cone shape. That same sand used and used to make a cone shape. Height of this cone is given as 24 centimeter. Radius and slant height of the cone they asked to find. What we want to do? Volume of the cone is equal to the volume of the bucket. Bucket is in which shape? Cylinder shape. Then unknown value, radius will getting. Radius getting after slant height, how to find? A formula apply. L is equal to square root of R square plus H square is the formula for finding a slant height. That formula apply and find out a slant height. That is the procedure for which question? Question number 7. So, what are the information they given in the question? First, we write information. Height of the bucket. Bucket is in cylinder. That's why height of cylinder is equal to cylinder they given as 32 centimeter. Next, radius of cylinder is given. Base radius. Radius of cylinder is given is equal to how much? 18 centimeter. Then height of cone is given there. So height of a cone is equal to 24 centimeter is the height of the cone. These are the information they gave in the question. Then same sand is used for making cone shape. That's why volume of the bucket is equal to volume of a cylinder. Here a cone case radius asked. That's why volume of cone first we write. So volume of cone is equal to volume of a cylinder. Volume of a cylinder. Cylinder is cylinder which shape have a bucket house. So volume of a cylinder. Volume of a cone. What is the formula? 1 by 3 pi a r square h is the formula for a volume of a cone. What is the volume of a cylinder? Pi r square h is the formula. Pi and pi right and left side we can cancel it. Then 1 by 3 into radius of the cone we don't know. Our aim is to find a radius. We don't know radius what. That's why r square h height of the cone how much they given? 24. Here height of radius of the cylinder is how much? 18. R square is there. 18 is multiplied 2 times. Height of the cylinder is how much? 32. Cancel 3 and 24 8 times. Again, right and left cancellation possible. 8 table 32. How many times? 4 times. Then left side r square only. Then right side part 18 into 4. This is r square value. What about r value? R radius value. R is equal to take a square root of 18 into 4. Easy only. Last year, 9th class you learned any number 2 times multiply and square root take in time. That number coming outside square 2 times repeating means one number take outside the square. So 18 is how many times repeated that 2 times. So 118 take outside. Square root of 4 become how much? 2 is the square root of 4. So 18 2s are how much? 36 centimeter is the radius of the cone. Therefore radius of cone become a 36 centimeter. We want a slant height also. They ask slant height of cone also. Slant height of the cone also they ask to find. slanted of cone for letter is L, that is equal to formula is square root of R square plus H square. R value is how much? 36 square plus H value is how much? 24. Height of the cone is 24. Then 36 square means 36 into 36 become 1296 plus 24 into 24 comes to be 576. Then adding to how much will come in 1872 square root to find out square root of 1872. How to square root to find a prime factorization doing and find out you need to place a 2. It is a even number, that's why we can able to divide it with 2. 2 table 89 times, 2 tables 7 3 times 6 remainder 1. 1 and 2 join in 10, 12, 2 table 12, 6 times. Again, unit place even number, that's why we can continue with the prime number 2. 2 table 9, how many times? 4 times 8 is the 9 minus 8 comes to be 1. 1 and 3 join in time 13, 30 not there, 2, 6 are 12 is the 30 minus 12 become 1. 1 and 6 join in time 16, 8 times. Again, 2 table unit place is 8, even number, that's why we continue 2, 3, 4. Again, unit place is 4, even number. Again, continue with 2, 1, 3, not there, 3, 2 into 1 become 2, 3 minus 2 become 1, 1 and 4, join in time 17. Again, next 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 7 comes to be 9. Prime number 3 possible, so dividing time 3 table 3 into 9, 3, 3 are 9 coming, then 11 minus 9 become 2, 2 and 7 joining time 27, 3 table 27, 9 times. Again 3 table possible, how many times? 13. 13 is a prime number, so 13 use and dividing, and then we get to divide and divide, final answer become 1. Then square root ask, square root means what we want to do? Pairing, pair and put it in the box. First box 1, 2 is common, the second box 1, 2 take outs, third box 1, 3 take outs, but 30 have no pair, that's why what we want to do, keep inside the root only, they are under a root only, then multiply into 2, 2 are 4, 4, 3 are how much? 12, so answer because how much? 12 root 13 centimeter is the slant height of the cone. I hope you can, slant height of the cone become 12 root 13 centimeter. Here 30 have no pair, here each pair one number take outside and multiply, no pair, not having pair number, keep inside the square root, that's why 13 is under the square root, so answer become 12 root 30 centimeter is the slant height. This is our 7th question. Next we go through the another question, 8th question. 8th question, they're telling about one water canal is there. Water canal is there, water canal is there, water is flowing there. Then width of that canal is given as 6 meter, 6 meter is the width. Then height of this canal, height of this canal is given as depth. Deep of this canal is given as 1.5 meter. Then the length is equal to the flow of the water. Flow of the water, rate of flow of water, they given as 10 kilometer per hour. That is equal to our length of our cube board. Canal is in which shape? A cube board shape. Once you imagine water canal is in a which shape? A cube board shape. Cube board length is the breadth is there, height is there, length is equal to the rate of water flow through that canal. That is 10 kilometer per hour they given. So they asking here within 30 minutes how much area of a field it can irrigate using this canal water, how much area of the field will irrigate within 30 minutes. Then some water they want to standing, then only we can able to irrigate in standing water. Also they given 8 cm they want water they want to stand, otherwise we can't able to irrigate. That also they give. So question, anyhow a question asking how much area of the field it can irrigating, how much over within 30 minutes they ask to find out area they asking. So first what are the information they given, that one first we write. Width represent as a breadth. Width represent as a breadth. Breadth is given as 6 meters. Then next height is given as equal to the depth of the canal. And they given as a deep of the canal is, deep means height, remember. The height is equal to 1.5. Rate of water flow is given. Water flow in canal is given. In canal, they given that is equal to L. How much rate of water? 10 kilometer per hour they given. Here see remaining all these units are meter. Here this unit only they given as a kilometer. So we want to convert kilometer to meter. 1 kilometer kane how much meter? 1000. So 10 is multiplied with 1000 meter per hour. So rate, length value represent as 10 into 1000. Meter per hour is the rate. Then next what they ask, within 30 minutes how much area of a field can be irrigated. So next volume, first we find out volume of water flow in a canal. A means 1 hour. Volume of water flow in 1 hour case find out. 1 hour case how to find out? Our canal is in which shape? Cube shape. What is the volume formula? Length into breadth into height. Here length is how much? 10 into 1000 is the length. Breadth is how much? 6 meters. Height is how much? 1.5. For avoiding decimal point, how we can write? Divided with 10. So 15 by 10, we can 10 and 10 cancel. Leave it remaining part, so we can write it as a, don't want to multiply, later we can multiply and write in that. Then this is the volume of flow in water in 1 hour. Then next they ask how much minute, 30 minutes case, this is 1 hour case. Volume of water flow in 30 minutes case find out. Volume of water flow in 30 minutes. In 30 minutes we want to find, that means 1 hour volume is multiplied with 30 minutes. Here also one problem, here see flow of water, length is, flow of water is in which form, hour case. This is our 30 minutes, 1 is in hour, 30 is in minutes. That's why we convert minute to hour, how to convert 1 hour containing how much minute, 60. That's why 30 is, question is in lowest unit convert to highest means divided division, so divided with 60. 0 cancel, 3 and 6 cancel in 10, 2 and 6 cancel in 3 5 are how much? 45. How many zeros are there? This much meter to volume of water flow in 30 minutes to become 45,000 meter cube is the volume part will get in. I hope you can understand what I say there. Then next, area asking, that is supposed to, this one, volume of water flow in 30 minutes gets volume ask, we are writing. They asking within 30 minutes how much area of the field can it can irrigating. Then one more last line they in question they given us water required for standing also it given that water what are required for standing? Required for standing. That also they given there, how much? 8 centimeter. This part converted to meter. Remaining all are in meter. This standing water they given us in centimeter. They given us smallest unit. Convert to highest means what we want to do? Division. Centimeter and meter relation is 100. That's why divided with 100. So this much meter, leave it. Leave it. So what we want to find? Area. Area will irrigate area will irrigate in 30 minutes we want. Area will irrigate in 30 minutes. Area will irrigate. Okay, that is suppose how much area of field will it irrigate? That is equal to volume of water. How to find out? We already found volume of water. Volume of water flow in 30 minutes divided with water required for standing. Water required for standing. Their division do in time we will get how much area it will irrigating. So volume of water flow in 30 minutes, how much we got? 45,000 divided with water required for standing is 8/100. Here one problem, 8/100 denominator part having a fractional number, what we want to do? Reciprocal take and multiply, continue here. So 45,000 is divided with 8 fractional. So otherwise you can write it as a reciprocal, right, and multiply 100 by 8. Then which table? 4 table is 4 table 8 2 times. 4 2s are 8. 4 into 25 become 100. Then 2 and this number both are this have unit place 0, even number. That's why possible 2 times. 5 means 2 times. Remainder 1. 10 means 5. So this much answer. Then this number is multiplied with 22,500 into 25 because how much coming? Multiply and MF 5,62,500 meters square. Area represent as in a meter square. 22,500 is multiplied with 25. Both are multiplying time that much area into area of the field will irrigate in there. Convert into hectare means what we want to do, divided with 10,000. You get a answer as in a hectare. So up to there enough. Here hectare not asking, we want in meter cases. So answer as right as in a meter. This is the meaning of that question. I hope you can understand this. So remaining exercise, next exercise, we can start next class. Thank you.